For the most part, DoD has responsibility for operations within restricted airspace. When you step outside of that military operating zone, that belongs to the National Airspace, and that responsibility is with the FAA. The National Airspace System was created with a person in the aircraft in mind, so now you have to think about all those things that the person would do that the unmanned aircraft also has to do in order to be safe. We kind of took off at Edwards, climbed up to 20,000 feet, and then we exited to the west. In order to achieve that ultimate goal of permitting unmanned aircraft to seamlessly operate in the NAS, we took this step. So this is a proving out of some sensors that can basically overcome what's missing from an unmanned aircraft, and that's a human in the cockpit with their eyes looking outside and detecting or seeing other aircraft and avoiding them.
NASA 870 traffic detected.
Some of these concepts that are easy for a person to accomplish are very hard from a technological perspective. So we wanted to prove out that we could detect and avoid other aircraft.
November 469 or Mike Bravo, traffic 4 moving to 3 o'clock, 1 mile, level at 900,000, an unmanned aerial vehicle. He'll be turning to the north in about 2 minutes across your nose, turning northbound at 900,000.
Roger, looking for a traffic 9 at Mike Bravo. No, Mike Bravo, I have good traffic in sight.
Silver 9 at Mike Bravo, roger, thanks. NASA 870, traffic, 12 o'clock, 3 miles eastbound, type and altitude unknown, primary radar target only.
With our sensors on board and also our display and the algorithms that are behind all of that, gives the pilot an equivalent level of capability to the human eye.
For this mission, the detect and avoid technology was awesome. It gave me a bigger picture of what's out there. Heavily reliant on air traffic control, keeping me separated from other aircraft, but having that big picture, we were able to see airliners, we were able to see general aviation aircraft, and just being aware of what's out there, I think we were better equipped to do this mission than any of the manned airplanes that were out there in the national airspace.
The technology in the past wasn't there. There wasn't a commerce reason for unmanned aircraft, but it's there now.
We can do long endurance, which is about 20 to 24 hours of flight time, which if you were sitting in the aircraft, you would not be able to do. This demonstration opens up opportunities for other unmanned airplanes to do new missions, pipeline patrol, wildfire studies, ice level studies, stuff like that. That's pretty mundane. This plane's well suited for long endurance, high altitude.
You may have heard that Amazon and some other companies would like to use unmanned aircraft to deliver packages. File and fly operations in the NAS would benefit them greatly. I think that someday there will be unmanned cargo aircraft, probably starting with the oceanic missions, flying unmanned cargo across the Pacific and the Atlantic. That commerce application seems to come to mind, and it's probably an end goal for unmanned aircraft.